So in the past three videos in this series, we've been working on an open source NPM package. We started by planning it, then we added the logic and a proper API, and we even added unit tests and continuous integration. But all the great libraries out there have something that we are still missing, which is good documentation. So in this video, we'll put together the documentation for our library, and we will also finally publish it in the NPM public registry. What's the first thing you do when you come across a new library or a new NPM package? In my case, I take a look at the README file. You gotta have a good README. It's the first thing that comes up in your GitHub repo and even your package's NPM page. So after researching popular libraries, I came up with a list of sections that I wanted our README to cover. First, we need an introduction. That's where we explain what our project's about and show a working example using a GIF or something. Then we need to show how easy it is to install it. I also wanted to add a usage section where we show different ways to create a scrollable area, how to scroll up and down, print, and any other important features. And finally, it's important to show that we have unit tests and how to run them. I figure most people will want to use this package with key precedents, so I decided to add a quick example and show how to do that. While I was writing the README, I realized I needed some nice looking examples for the GIFs and code samples. This wasn't a part of the plan, so I had to have a talk with my project manager to see if we could make some room for a small task to add a few examples to the repo. Luckily, he was on board. These examples will be useful both for potential users and for me to complement the automated tests. I can use them to run some manual tests before publishing. Thank you. I also ended up writing a new NPM script to easily execute the examples with NPM run, bypassing a parameter that indicates which examples you want to run. So we got a README, but we are still not quite done with documentation. The last thing I want to do is to document the code with JSDoc. In case you haven't heard about JSDoc, here's a quick intro. It's an open source API documentation generator for JavaScript. You use it to document your code through comments. But the best thing about JSDoc is that VS Code and other editors have built-in support for it, which means that when other devs install our library and start using it, they will have access to its documentation right there alongside their code. Now that we are done with the documentation, it's time to learn how to publish an NPM package. Here's what we need. First, we need an NPM account. That's easy, just sign into NPM. We are also going to quickly take a look and refactor our build settings. As you can see, I'm just changing the output folder so that the distribution build and the builds for the test and examples are generated in different directories. I'll explain why in a minute. Before the refactor we just did, we used to have a single distribution directory right here that included all our builds. That means the build for the running the test, the build for the examples, and the build for the actual package, which is actually these four files. Now that's a little messy, so let's see what happens if we remove this directory and run the build scripts again, but after the refactor we just did. As you can see, we have now two new directories. One includes the builds for the examples at the tests. And if we take a look here, you can see that this build includes only the tests and the source code that is used to run those tests. And the examples build includes only the examples and the source code as well. But if we take a look here in this distribution directory, we will see that it only contains the files that we need to publish for this package to work, which are the declaration files and the transpile files that were transpiled from TypeScript to JavaScript, right? And you may have noticed that this build includes the declaration files and these other two builds don't. And that's thanks to the extended tsconfig files that we generated for each of these builds. So if we take a look here, you can see that there's a tsconfig JSON within the examples directory, and there's also a tsconfig JSON in the root directory, and there's another tsconfig JSON here in the test directory. And if we take a look at this tsconfig JSON, we can see that there's a property that says declaration true, which is what makes this distribution, this build, include the declaration files. But if we take a look at this tsconfig JSON, we can see that it extends the root tsconfig JSON, but it also overrides this property and probably a few more to specify that it doesn't want, we don't want the declaration files in this build. And the same goes for the examples build. We don't want the declaration files, we don't want the source map files. So that way we can make sure to only generate the files that we want for each of the builds. Now keep in mind, we want to keep this package as lean as possible, so we don't want to include anything that's not really needed. All we need our package to include is the transpile files, so these two, the declaration files, and also the package JSON, which is automatically included, and the README file, which is also automatically included as long as it's in the root directory. Luckily, configuring what we want to include is fairly simple. We just need to set the files property in the package JSON. We also need to set the types property, which points to our type declaration files, making sure NPM knows that the package has built-in TypeScript support. And finally, we should take a look at the package JSON and make sure to fill out the properties that might be useful to describe our package, like version, description, author, keywords, etc. Before actually publishing the package, we should make sure we are publishing the last build. To prevent issues with that, we can add a prepack script. This script is automatically run by npm when we run the publish command. That way we get a new up-to-date build before every publish. Once all of that's done, we need to log in to npm from the terminal. And finally, just run the publish command. It feels awesome to have finally published an NPM package of my own, and that it actually solves a problem. I'm not sure if people will use it, honestly, but it's still pretty cool. There are obviously things I would like to add and improve still, like automated releases and add more features, but I couldn't justify investing even more time in this small project right now. I mean, it can be tempting to keep coding forever, trying to make the project perfect, but then the project will probably end up unfinished in a private repo, and what would be the point? So I hope you enjoyed this little project walkthrough series that's been going on for the past few weeks. I really did, and I have a long list of projects that I want to work on and share with you, similar to this one. So if you enjoyed this, consider subscribing, and until next time, keep coding and have fun!